Ni hao, Yan Yan Food Tubers. Chef Michael here in Australia. Today I'm going to continue my baking odyssey, and I'm going to show you how to make a Swiss roll, which is an interesting cake because it's a rolled up sponge cake, and I'm going to make a lovely strawberry filling for it, and you'll use cream in it as well. First up, I've got to line my Swiss roll tin, which is 25 centimetres by 35 centimetres, by only about two or three centimetres deep, not very deep at all. So let's go and line it. So here I have a piece of baking paper, slightly over the size of my tin, and just make four little incisions. Then I'm going to fold the sides up and the ends. And with a little bit of greasy paper and butter, I'm just gonna grease the sides of the tin. That'll just make sure that the paper sticks to the sides of the tray. And there we have my tin, all ready to go for my Swiss roll. Now that my baking tin is lined, before I make my sponge cake, I'm going to make my strawberry filling. The reason being is that I'm going to cook the strawberries down in a little bit of sugar and a little bit of water, and I need them to be completely cool before I spread them onto my sponge. So let's go to it. So here I have 300 grams of strawberries. Now all I'm going to do is I'm going to cut the green part of the top off, and I'm going to slice them into quarters. So into a saucepan, on the stove go my strawberries, along with a tablespoon of water and quarter cup of sugar. Now I'm just going to turn on the heat, and I'm just going to slowly cook them down for about 20 minutes, stirring occasionally, until all those strawberries are broken down and into a jam-like mixture. And then they can just sit on a very low heat. Through the cooking process, the strawberries will release a lot of moisture and liquid, and then eventually they'll break down as they're cooked into a lovely pulpy consistency. We can just continue to smash those strawberries up against the side of the saucepan. So that's taken about 20 minutes, and that's ready to be put aside, taken off the heat, and allowed to cool completely. Well, now that my strawberry filling is done and it's on the stove cooling, it's time to make the sponge. Four simple ingredients, let's have a look. So for this recipe, you'll need 5 eggs, 120 grams of caster sugar, and in here I've got 100 grams of plain flour, and into that I'm going to put 1 teaspoon of baking powder and sift it in. So into my mixing bowl, I've put my 5 eggs and my 120 grams of caster sugar. Now, onto my mixer. And I'm gonna mix those for about 10 to 12 minutes until they're light and fluffy. Now that's been beating for about 7 to 10 minutes. And there's lots of air in there, lots of volume.
There's lots of air bubbles in there, nicely aerated.
And that's what you want in a sponge cake, lots of aeration in that egg and sugar mixture. Now, on with the next part of the process is to put my flour into my egg mixture. And I'm just gonna gently do that in 3 batches. So a little bit at first. I don't wanna knock too much of that air out, so I'm just gonna fold it in very gently, making sure that it's well mixed in before I add the next bit. So, here's my baking tray. In goes my mixture. And then with my palette knife, I'm just gonna even that out and make sure the top is nice and even and level and smooth. And now, that's ready for the oven. So in it goes, at 180 degrees for about 10 to 12 minutes. So while that's in the oven, I've got time to prepare my tea towel, because as soon as it comes out of the oven, once it's slightly cooled, I've got to roll it up in that tea towel, hence the reason it's called a Swiss roll. So onto a tea towel, I'm just gonna sprinkle a little bit of caster sugar. And now that's ready for my sponge when it comes out of the oven. So that's been 10 minutes. Let's have a look. Yep, perfectly golden brown. That's done. We don't want to overcook it, otherwise it'll crack when we roll it up. Let's get it out of the oven. Now, I'm just going to let that cool for a little bit, and then I'm going to turn it out onto my sugared tea towel. Okay, that's now quite sufficiently cooled, so I'm just going to quickly invert that onto my sugared tea towel, just carefully releasing the baking paper. And then with a sharp knife, I'm just going to put little, quick little nicks along the edge. This will help just to release the cake a little bit and easier to roll. So then taking my tea towel, I'm going to roll the sponge gently up and over and leave it there like that, rolled up to cool completely. Now, while my sponge is cooling, I want to be really cold. I'm going to prepare the rest of my filling. I'm putting 250 mils of whipping cream into my bowl, along with half a teaspoon of vanilla extract. Onto my mixer, and I'm just going to whip that until a soft peak. That is done. Now, my sponge is cool, so let's get decorating. Gently unroll your sponge, and this is the strawberry I prepared earlier. Just gonna spread that out evenly. Then I'm going to dollop my beautiful whipped cream. Then again, with my palette knife, just evenly spread it out to all the corners. And then once again, with my tea towel, I'm just going to fold over the edge like that. Just do it very gently and roll that up. And then I'm just going to pick my sponge up and I'm just going to pop it on a tray with some baking paper in it. And then I'm going to pop it in the fridge. So there's my Swiss roll. I'm just going to pop that in the fridge for about half an hour just to let the cream set a little bit. Now my Swiss roll has set in the fridge. I'm ready to finish it off. So first thing I need to do is just to take a sharp straight edge knife and trim both the edges off. Then I'm just gonna take a little bit of icing sugar in a sieve and I'm gonna dust the top. Get excited, here's my lovely, beautiful, delicious Swiss roll with my very special homemade strawberry filling. Ooh, let's have a little taste. Oh, that strawberry filling is delicious. Wonderful. Until next time, bye-bye.